Hi friends, so today we will be looking how to do a structured hexahedral meshing for a pipe geometry or simply a circular cylinder. So for doing that, I have created a circular cylinder geometry using geometry tool in ANSYS, and the radius of the geometry is 0.5 meter and length is 6 meter. Actually, what we are going to do is that we are just directly creating a model in Design Modeler and directly importing into ICM CFD here. Actually, you can import any kinds of models from different softwares such as SolidWorks or any other modeling software. I will just show you how to import that also. So this video will give you a basic idea on how to use ICM CFD and how to work with all the tools in that. So just double click on it and let's wait till it opens. So now our geometry is loaded. So in order to see the geometry, what you have to do is that just go to the geometry tree over here, click on the points and surfaces. So now you can see the points, surfaces and the curves, all you can see, but this is in a wireframe. If you need to see it in a solid model, just click on this solid display. So now you can see the solid display. So now you can see different parts are colored in different color. That's because we have done the name selection in Design Modeler itself. So this is our inlet, this is our outlet, and this is the wall. To verify the color, you can just go to the parts and see the inlet is in blue and others are in the same as that. You can actually do the name selection ICM CFD also. For that, you just need to right click on the parts, create new parts. If you need to create an inlet, just type inlet and click on the part you need. As I have done this earlier in Design Modeler itself, I'm not doing it right now. Now we'll move on how to do a meshing, structured meshing on circular cylinder. Okay, so for that, initially just let's move to the wireframe and switch off the surface and points. We only need the curves initially. So initially we need to repair the geometry to capture the wall, all the curves in the geometry. Okay, so just go to the repair geometry over here and just click on apply. So automatically your curve should be highlighted in red color, and you can see a tolerance button here or a tolerance value here. These tolerance values directly proportional like how complicated your geometry is. If you are having a very complicated geometry with the lower tolerance, you cannot capture all the curves. So if your geometry is a bit more complicated, you can increase the tolerance value. Generally, if you directly import and go to the repair geometry, it will automatically calculate, and most probably all the curves will be highlighted to red. If not, you can just increase the tolerance value. So once the curves get highlighted to red, now we need to do a blocking. So basically, blocking is a process where you will be creating a cuboid around the circular cylinder body such that it encloses the body. Okay, so we'll see that. So here is the main tab. This is the geometry, mesh, blocking, edit mesh, properties. These mesh are for non-structural meshing or non-structured meshing. So since we are doing structured meshing, we'll go for blocking. For the thing to note is that for all structured meshing, we need blocking. Okay, so just go to blocking and go to the first option, click on it, and you have to change the part to fluid. Okay, why is this? Because if you are keeping it as a solid and doing, there will be no problem. But when you import it to the solver will detect the whole body as a solid and there will be some error popping up. So in order to avoid that, we are changing it to fluid. If you forgot to change this name to fluid at first, no problem. With the solver, there is an option. There will be option to change it to fluid again. Okay. So now what you have to do is just change the name to fluid and go to the initializing block. It should be 3D bounding block. If you are doing for a 2D surface, you can go for 2D planar. Okay. So go for 3D bounding blocks. Click on apply. So as you can see, a cuboid has created around the circular cylinder. So the next step we are going to do is that we are going to associate this edge with respect to this curve so that this whole cuboid is inside the circular cylinder. So we can do this in this like this, like go to the association tab. This is associate tab. Okay, click on that And here you are having different option. This is the vertex to edge association. This is the edge to curve association. This is the edge to surface association. So what we are going to do is that now we are going to associate these edges to this curve. So we'll go for this option. Initially we need to select the edges. So let's select the edges 1, 2, 3, 4. And in order to confirm the selection, you have to click your center mouse button. Okay. So once you click it, that will go and automatically the edges will be selected. Now you have to click the curve directly. Just click on the curve and again press the center mouse button. Okay. So when the curve changes to a green color, it means that it is associated with some kind of edges. Okay. So now we have to do the same for this side also. I'll just do it firstly. Yes. So the both association are completed. Now what we have to do is that we have to project these vertices inside the circular cylinder. For that we are having a project option, snap project vertices. Click on that, make sure all visible is switched on and click on apply. So now you can see that the cuboid is actually projected inside the circular cylinder. Now we'll just show you like how the pre-mesh looks now. Just click on the pre-mesh and click on yes. To see the whole solid body, right click on the pre-mesh and click on solid wire. So you can see this is the current mesh we have. We can actually increase the number of divisions over this side. Currently we are having 1, 2, 3, 4 elements, 5, 6 on this side, like that we are having each elements on each side. We can increase it such that the mesh actually adapts the curvature of the circular cylinder. For doing that, let's initially just switch off the solid thing, like switch off the pre-mesh and go to the pre-mesh parameter tabs. Just here it is under the blocking here. Just click on that and you can give the sizing here, edge parameter, and just click on any of the edges and you can specify the number of nodes. So let me give the total number of nodes on this side is, let it be 12. Okay, this is a random value. And there is one more feature in ICM CFD, you can copy the parameters to all relative edges. See what happens when I switch it on. It copies to all parallel edges. So this will make your work more easier. Okay. And we'll give the values for the other side also. We'll give it 12. And for the center line, we'll give it like 20. 20 will be fine, I guess. Okay. So now if you need to see what null divisions you have given for each edges, just go to the edges tab, right click on it and show on counts. So now you can see like what are the number of knots in each of the edges. Now go to the pre-mesh, just right click on pre-mesh and click on yes. So now you can see we are able to capture the geometry perfectly, but there are some problems with this mesh. Actually, if you are seeing with the elements over this side, as number of elements increases, the skewness and aspect ratio of elements over the side will be reducing and quality of the mesh will reduce drastically. So in order to avoid that, there is a technique called O-grid technique. So we will be using the O-grid technique to improve the mesh quality. For that, initially just switch off the pre-mesh and we are going to create a grid which will be same as a cuboid inside, which will be connecting with the edges of the outer cuboid. So you will understand once I make the O-grid. So for making the O-grid, just go to the split block button and go for the O-grid block. This is the second option at the split block. Click on it and click on the boxes, plus boxes. You can actually click, yes, we are only having presently one box over here. Just click on the one box and click on the faces. Sorry, click on the one box and don't forget to press the center button to apply it. So now you can see a cuboid is created. Now what we need is that we need this surface of the cuboid to be extended till the surface of this circle. For that we need to include the faces also. So just click on the faces, click on the two surfaces and click on enter. So our cuboid is almost ready. So now to create the O-grid, just click on apply. So you can see a small cuboid has created inside this and inside this. So this will improve our geometry very well. So we are having an extra edge over here. So we need to give sizing for that also. So we'll go to edge parameter, will give sizing as like 20 will be fine. Okay, 20. Okay, I guess 20 will be very high. I'll go with 10. Click on apply. Now click on pre-mesh. So now you can see how the elements have changed from previous shape to now. Now all the elements are having a very good structure, and they will be able to capture all the flows very accurately. Okay, so just switch off there just to see the mesh correctly. So if you are concerned, like you need more number of elements towards the wall so that you will be able to capture the flow properly. For that, what you can do is that just switch off the pre-mesh, switch on the edges, go for the edge parameter and click on the edge. Okay, so once you click on the edge, you will be having spacing 1, spacing 2, like this parameters over here. So one thing to be noted is that you can see an arrow mark when you click an edge. The point where the arrow mark is pointing, or the direction towards the arrow mark is pointing, is this spacing 2, and the initial space is the initial point is the spacing 1. Okay, so if you need more number of elements over this side, what you need to give is that you have to adjust the spacing 1. So spacing 1 is nothing but the distance between this point and the first element. Okay, these distance is specified here. So let us specify it as 0.001. And ratio is nothing but the growth rate. Okay, like how it should grow from this point to the other point. So I will give like 1.1, which means that the first element will be having 0.001 spacing. After that, the second element and first element spacing will be like 10% more than this value. Like that, it will go till here. Okay, so just click on apply and you can see how it changes. So just click on pre-mesh. So you can see large number of elements are near to the surfaces. But as you can see, we need to increase the number of elements so as to create a uniform mesh. So we'll just increase it to 25. Okay, now let's give pre-mesh. Now you can see we have created a very good mesh, and the number of elements towards the wall are very good. Okay, now just switch off the edges to see the mesh. Okay, so the other side also looking good. So now we are done with the mesh. So in order to verify the quality of the mesh, what you can do is that just go to quality parameter over here, click on it, and there are different criterions for it. The basic criterion is like go to the first ankle tab and click on apply. So for most of the solver would accept the elements which are having angle above 18 degree only. If any of the element is having angle less than 18 degree, it won't accept. So if you are doing some kind of complicated geometry, you should make sure that all the elements are above 18 degree so as the solver would accept it. So currently we are having a very good mesh. Our minimum quality is 49.68 degree, and maximum angle is 90 degree. And the second parameter is the determinant 2×2×2. Just click on the criterion, click on apply. Okay, so now you can see the criterion, like determinant tab over here. For determinant, if the determinant is greater than 0.2, your geometry is great, very good. Okay, and if you move towards the one side, it will be very good. The quality of the mesh will be increasing towards the one. Okay, so now we can see that our minimum value is 0.686 and maximum is 1, which is very good. So we are done with the meshing, and we have ensured the quality of the meshing too. So next, what you have to do is that we have to import this to any solver. Okay, so for that, what you have to do is that just go to pre-mesh, right click on it and click on convert to unstructured mesh. Okay, so it has automatically been converted to unstructured mesh. Now what we have to do is that we have to choose the solver with which we are going to solve the problem. Okay, so here I am going to use Ansys Fluent. If you go to the drop down over here, you can see Ansys Fluent, Ansys CFX and other software here. So whatever software you need, just click on that. And one more thing, we have to save this geometry before moving on to the solver. Okay, so we'll just click on the save project. I'll just save it in the desktop. Just save it as some name. Okay. Okay, now it is it has been saved. Now we'll go to the Ansys Fluent and click on it. So the translation has also been done. So we are done with the mesh. Just close the ICM CFD tab, and I will show you like how to import this mesh to the solver, that is Fluent. So go to the fluid flow and just drag the ICM CFD to the setup. Okay, let's just double click on the setup. So that's it, friends. Now we have imported the geometry to the Fluent solver, and if you need to ensure the quality, once again just go for the mesh checking in solving software. And in Access Fluent, if you are getting this kind of message, it means that your mesh is good. Or else if you are having the angle less than 18 degree or the determinant is very nearer to zero, what happens is that negative volume elements will be created in your geometry. So you will be getting an error message saying like left hand face is detected or negative volume detected. Okay, so make sure you are having a angle greater than 18 degree and the determinant should be greater than 0.2 to ensure the good quality of mesh. So thank you for watching the video. If you like the video, do like and subscribe my channel. And if you are having any doubts or suggestions for doing some kind of geometry, just comment in the comment section. Thank you for watching.